Hello, 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 everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the bakery. I'm Berry Pies, and today we are live with something a little different on this Friday. Funriety Friday is supposed to be a day where we have a variety of games. And we haven't. We've been just playing Xenoblade Chronicles, which is great. It's fun. But we're actually almost done with the first game, which is really exciting. We're only a couple chapters away from the finale. Hi, Rocky. I would really like to finish that, but I've also been wanting to play something scary, and that was one of the things we used to play on Fridays. Among our variety was always at least one or two horror games, and we haven't done that in a while. So, Alan Wake's Remastered was on sale for like. It was either 15 or $20, and I showed the trailer to Posh, and they were like, "Oh, that looks really scary." And I was like, "Well, I actually have started this game like three different times and have yet to ever finish it, and I really want to play Control and Alan Wake 2." So we've decided we are going to go ahead and fucking play the shit out of this. And we're gonna play on easy because I'm not looking to be stressed out while playing a horror game.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations.
Wait, hold on. Can we get. Thank you. See how that.
Hypothetical question.
Yeah, there we go, like a fucking
In a
movie.
horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be
Welcome
one.
back from ads, Rocky.
Unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
I aspire to be like Stephen King. Who is not a bad writer? I just wish sometimes he would slow down and
I
stop trying
always
to
had a
shit
vivid
out a book.
imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes.
Yeah, well, we'll have to do a movie sometime
Another
again.
typical
I
nightmare.
miss watching TV and
Traveling,
movies with you guys,
desperately
but
trying to reach my destination, the lighthouse. For some urgent reason I couldn't remember, I've been driving too fast down the coast road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Bitch, he gone. Bye, Felicia.
Suddenly, his body was gone.
Yeah, it is. Episode one,
I was in shock from the
Nightmare.
crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
I don't understand why anyone plays where down is up and up is down. L1 is sprint. Okay, right is joy, right is camera.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
No, leave me alone, leave me alone, leave me alone. Yeah, I don't like inverse controls. I don't understand the purpose of them. Why do you want down up and up as down? I don't get that. I've never understood that. Even growing up, when I would play Doom on the computer, like old school Doom, I couldn't play it like that. I would have to change the controls. Oh my god! Ah! There's so much happening right now. This is not the time to get tired during your running. Oh my god, run, you moron. Well, in my experience, most thrillers don't have jump scares. They're just tense. And maybe once in a while has a moment that makes you go, oh, good Jesus. But a horror movie has me doing, oh, Jesus, a lot. And I don't know, thrillers usually wind up being like crime and like crime scene investigation, like The Bone Collector. That was a thriller, not a horror movie. I'm just trying to think of other movies. I'm sorry. Bear with me. You're right, there was no up and down in the original Dooms. Wow, I haven't played the original Dooms since I was, like, fucking literally a child. Let's see, Bone Collector, that would be a killer. That would be a thriller movie. Scream, horror. Tons of jump scares. Get Out? I actually consider Get Out more a thriller. The fuck? Oh.
Well, Buffalo, I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No, I don't. Exactly.
Teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping out. When it
Yeah, I feel like psychological horrors are definitely... Victory!
Remember what I taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Bitch! Shit, my battery's almost out. I gotta be careful. There are moments in this game that I really hate. They really frustrate me. So bear with me when we get there. It's not for a while. There's moments where you have to run through the forest, but because there's no light, the enemies just kind of come in an endless supply. So it's, like, really frustrating because you'll kill, like, three and then run and then, like, minute later, there's another three suddenly chasing you. And sometimes they don't make noise. So you have no clue until there's an axe whipping through the air at your fucking head. Oh my god. It's my least favorite part of the game. Yes! Flare gun! And this is how we do it. Oh. That was convenient, eh? Oh, could you? I don't think I could. I was running towards the light, you asshole. You changed the view on me. I couldn't see where I was going. Oh. I didn't know I could turn the camera. I thought it was one of those that's coming at you. Run! Why is there no stamina bar? Like, I'd like to know how long I have to run before I'm running out of it. Yeah, maybe. There's no stamina bar, and there wasn't in the original either, and I never thought that made sense, because plenty of games have a stamina bar for when you're running, so you know when you get tired. Not this game. You're just all of a sudden, and I get it, you're a writer, you're not gonna be physically fit for this stuff, so I don't expect him to be, like, running endlessly, but I would like a bar so I know how much longer I have to run.
Baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
We're here.
Emotional damage.
Yep. That is definitely some emotional damage going on there, buddy.
Emotional damage.
Welcome to Bright Falls. Well, thank you. I feel so welcomed.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman.
You want me to act like we're on vacation?
Sure.
Don't mind me. I'm just a famous book publisher. Writer. What's up, old dude? This bitch wants me to take a picture with you. Because we're on vacation. Deer Fest? The fuck is Deer Fest? Nice to meet you too, sir.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure.
That's Mr. Wake to you. I feel so welcomed and safe. Right? Inner town of Bright Falls. How could anything go wrong with a name like that?
We could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand. Fair enough. You can trust me to be this. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you do have a...
I'm not gonna change my mind. But thanks. Stay old. I did. It was all right. Let's not make a thing about it. Oh, God.
Are you there yet?
It's Barry. Oh, I'm Barry. Oh, American Dad, I love you so much. Great. Barry is like... Barry's like that scheming uncle you have that lives in, like, Florida and somehow always has money, but, like, doesn't work or do anything, and he's always on his next crazy scheme. Yeah, that's him. Hawaiian shirt in everything.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry.
Barry. Hi, Barry. Oh, that was delayed. Hawaiian shirts in every season, darling. Hey. First of all, Alan Wake is from the 360, okay? Before John Wick was nothing more than a thought in some dude's nutsack, okay? So let's not go there first, okay? Second of all, this is horror, not you killed my dog, so now I'm back out of retirement and I'm gonna fucking kill all of you, okay? It's not the same thing. Different spectrums of the creative rainbow here. Let's give Alan Wake his flowers, Barry. Flowers. Get back into the car. Which one's our car? Bitch, which one? Oh, it's probably the nice one. Yeah, it's the nice one. I should have thought so. I didn't watch her get in. Mr. Carl Stuckey. Who names the characters in some of these games? Carl Stuckey.
I love you too.
Dude. If it's the picture I think it is, he looks literally like young Keanu Reeves. It's disgusting.
I'd forgotten there were still places like this.
Like, he could be Keanu Reeves' like twin. Welcome to the O'Dear Diner. And I know oftentimes they try to get stunt doubles who look like the actor, but I swear to God, sometimes they just clone the motherfuckers. And they're like, there you go. He's gonna do your stunts so nothing happens to the real you. Because we can make more of these. Oh no, I'm sorry Twitch crashed on you, Rocky.
I've got all your books.
Do you listen, fangirl?
When they took it out of the window.
Hey, Lugnir.
Well, okay. Good for you.
We were talking about how the stunt double for Keanu Reeves. No, oh my god, I haven't seen that. I haven't watched anything on the new John Wick movie because I'm, like, waiting because a lot of times I find that the John Wick movies put some of their best fight scenes in the trailers or online, and I don't want it spoiled. So I'm, like, gonna watch the trailer once, and then that's it. Other than that, I don't want to see anything on the movie. I am obsessed with the John Wick movies. They're, like, the Bourne movies, but, like, good, you know? Oh, it wasn't a trailer or anything? Oh, if it's just like a clip, I'll totally check that out. Yeah, you want some more? Go for it. Sorry, guys, I had to refresh my coffee. It's literally just a guy in a mocap suit falling downstairs. Oh, okay. That actually sounds pretty amusing. The things that these stunt doubles can do blow my mind. Like, the way they're taught how to, like, fall in certain ways. Like, I still won't understand the science on some of them, because I watch some of them, and I'm like, how did that neck not snap in, like, 23 different fucking places? I know you're professionally trained, but it still defies the laws of logic to me. Like, some of the things these fucking guys can do, and ladies.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Hey, don't be talking about how I live my coffee life, okay? I will have as much goddamn coffee as I please. Speak.
Favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now.
Oh, could you? Did that motherfucker just call me Sonny?
I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation.
Bad circulation.
Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable. It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack.
Yeah, baby. I'll have to do that, Ethan.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Those two are, like, super weird. I want to go in! I'm staff! I'm not staff. I lied. I'm sorry. That's not nice. Mm-hmm. Bitch, what is going on down there?
You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky. Get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Rocky?
Carl couldn't make it.
Who? That was creepy. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. Yeah, Rocky, seriously, that bitch just popped up out of nowhere. I would prefer if you didn't. No, no, I don't want any of that. No, I do not. I insist you don't. I insist you stay the fuck away from my cabin, bitch. Oh, and you're just gonna stand there? Oh, no! Oh, I don't like her. I forgot about her. Oh, did I? Bitch, you crazy. I'm gonna call the men in white. Girl, they gonna handle you. Mm-hmm. They gonna do that.
The Andersons, they're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did they wander off? They just stroll out of the fucking hospital like no, there's no security? Where are we? People just wander out of the hospitals. We got crazy ass bitches looking down dark hallways. I got fucking... Was she a widow? Is she grieving? She's... I don't know, but she's handing me papers in dark hallways and insisting that she comes by and meets my wife. I don't like any of this. I don't like any... No, I'm not staying in town for the Deer Fest, bitch. I'm going. Oh, girl, you have no clue how many of those I'm going to need.
Hey, wait. Mrs. Wake. Your keys.
No. 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 The lady in the hallway gave me keys. The lady in the hallway gave me keys. What do you mean, my keys?
Can you believe this?
What do you mean, my keys? That bitch just gave me keys. Okay. Well, I don't know what just happened, but I've got keys for something. Oh, God. Oh, God. I don't like this. I actually don't remember him not giving me the keys. I haven't played this game since, like, the 360, y'all. No, that's not true. I tried to pick it up, like, 6 years ago, 7 years ago. Again, for the second time, and I got distracted. I always get distracted when I try to play this game. But I'm glad that we're giving the remaster a go, because, honestly, the controls feel better in this than they did in the original game. Like, the dodging mechanics in the original game were clunky.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Girl, come on! I mean, to be fair, I guess I could have grabbed a bag or two. But, like, girl, work it. Come on. Yeah, seriously? This whole town just gives me the ick.
Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Oh, sure, honey. I'll get right on it, honey. Let me just figure out how to turn the lights on, honey! Hey, lights, are you up here? What the fuck's in here? Oh, I don't like that. I don't like flashes of evil.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
The fuck is that? Dude, is that like a doll or like a scuba gear? The fuck is going on? Okay, so I'm not gonna lie. When I first played this game, the two times I played this, I don't think I ever explored the house. I think I just went outside and figured out how to turn the lights on with the generator. So I don't know what this is, if this is a reference to anything. But like, it looks like a clay doll of some kind. Okay.
The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
Anything in here? Interesting. Nothing in here. More dialogue was triggered, so that's pretty cool. I've definitely never been into either of those two rooms. I usually just turn the power on. So that was cool. We found that picture up there. We found the coffee. We got to keep our eyes out for the coffee canisters. They're the collectibles in this game.
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Oh, if I remember correctly, Thomas Zane is a reference to something, and I can't tell you guys what, because I'm not sure.
The Deer Fest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Famous artist, no less.
Dude! You weren't supposed to tell anybody I'm... Oh, I guess he didn't say my name, Alan. I guess I can't get mad. But still, dude, shut your fucking mouth. No one's supposed to know I'm fucking here, bro. Oh, all right. Oh, generator. Where the fuck are you? Ah, wait.
The island had once been the site for the story. Maybe it would be that again.
Well, bitch, I tried to go into the shed and it, like, totes wouldn't let me. Can I, like, Dead by Daylight this and, like, spring through the window? No? Alright, that's fine. Let me in, whore! Let me in. Let me in, little pig! Oh. Connected to the power cable. Open the doorknob, Barry. Okay, so yeah. Pulling the generator seems easy enough, but try doing that when there's, like, four shadow men trying to fucking kill you. That little tap the X to pull the rope becomes less easy than it looks. Thank God I put this on easy mode. Oh, are they? Yeah, you go do that. Go wipe that snatch, bitch. I'll meet you upstairs in 5. Oh, I'll have loads of fun, sweetheart. Loads.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work.
Well, I don't know how we're in the mansion. I mean, the apartment, the cabin, because apparently we don't have the keys. So, I'd like to know how we got inside. That light looks awfully welcoming. Is it lingerie? Yeah, baby.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study.
Oh god. Damn it.
Okay.
Surprise.
Oh, you shouldn't have.
Confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past.
Damn, Alice, you everyone
Hey, 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 just hear me out. There's a local doctor. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe. So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not...
There was a face in the darkness.
I don't want to hear it. God.
Oh, bitch. I'm pretty sure it was the old lady.
I knew she wouldn't.
About wet my pants.
I needed some time alone.
Oh, no. I was not ready for that. Diver's Isle. Maybe it really was a diving suit then. Called Diver's Isle. Fuck off! Have a good night, Rocky. Thanks for coming, buddy. Wait. I'm in a car?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice.
All right.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use.
All right.
It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
To the gas station.
Damn.
Well, I guess it's a good thing we got out of there when we could. When we did. Fucking A, bro.
Hello? Someone there? The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started.
Oh.
I named the author.
Oh.
Murderer in the woods at night.
Oh, great. I'm so excited. That sounds fucking fabulous.
Departure by Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Alan Wake. Sorry, that was corny. I didn't like that.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
No. 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 Uh-uh.
Hey. Hey, you.
Phil.
There's been an accident. I need help.
Listen. What's it?
I need to.
Premium cabins for rent in.
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Sure, no refund. Got it, buddy. Ah! Oh.
The taking stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater. Like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Well, I don't have a flashlight, bitch.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second, Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
It's the latest
thing. Yes.
Right ball sheriff station.
Hello?
Oh, bitch, of course he did.
Outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone or something. There were no bodies, they just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Oh, okay. Oh, you suck, ball sack.
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Oh, cool. Yes! Group attack! Group attack! Oh, revolver ammo. Never have enough of that stuff.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Okay. Alright, here we go. Bitch, I will fuck you up! Oh, I did not mean to shoot that. Well, that's a waste of a flare. No, he's dead, right? This looks like something. Like some off-trail exploring. Yep. Would have missed the manuscript page.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
Oh, that fucking waitress girl from the diner at the beginning of the game. Oh boy. All right. I don't know, but that was fucking made my butt cheeks clench.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
All right,
Stucky was still out there.
Yeah, I saw.
Stalking me.
It's horrifying. Bitch! Oh, boy. Okay.
Staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Okay. Oh, there's some supplies here, so let's... Still no revolver ammo, huh? Right is how you switch guns. Okay. Left, right. Okay.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Right over there. I'm just very scared right now. Yep! Yes! I got two for the price of one, bitch! Burned out both of their flash- their fucking shadows. What? It was hot. I'm proud of me.
With all this forestry equipment around, I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Horrifying.
Something I could use to reach the top.
Did I just get up a fucking shotgun? Did I just get a fucking shotgun? I did, bitch, what? All right. Wait a minute. Almost missed out on the coffee thermos. Is there a pathway over here? I feel like there was. Oh? Hey! What? I didn't know this was here. What's up here? Oh! Is that a cap? No way. What the fuck is up here? Well, look at that. Very nice. Extra supplies? I'll take it. That seriously hurt me. I barely dropped, like, at all. Really? Okay. Cool. Whatever. Okay. All right, what's over here? A little cabin? Shotgun ammo. There's a radio in here, I hear.
Well, I was just outside for a breath.
Listen to this for a second.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby
sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but when we were pretty far from home and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but just too dumb for the hood.
Poor man's dog is gone.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice. The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the street. Belly Burster is the best with no curves.
No. Oh god, I remember this. I think this is one of those endless spots I was talking about. No, stop, you idiot! Let go of the fucking generator! Fuck! Ow! What the fuck that? I didn't even press the goddamn generator. What the fuck? Way to be a dumb fuck, dude. I pressed the R1 to dodge. I don't know why the hell he grabbed the fucking generator. Wait, I don't... See, this is my problem with this part. I always get fucking lost. Okay. Because I'm, like, too busy freaking out that I'm being chased by, like, 700 things. I always get lost here. I can never figure out where the fuck I'm going. This is bullshit. Ow! Fuck off! Alright, let's go! Okay, light. Stay here for a second. Fuck. No! No! Ho! Ho! Ho, ho, ho. We all take a minute. Oh, thank God. I'm gonna take a minute. Outer Limits. This is supposed to be a spoof on Twilight Zone. Excuse me, not Outer Limits.
Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is all
fascinating.
I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality.
Ooh! Oh, well, I guess it's supposed to be plugged in.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman. The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. truth of what I'd faced the previous night.
Oh shit.
She'd think I was lying.
Yep.
Crazy. She'd lock me up.
Mm.
And she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Ah. These are all facts. Bitch.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
That was like fucking nerve-wracking. It was our first taste of a boss fight. Any pages around here? I'm not about to run off without at least looking. Anything over here? Just like chilling out. Oh, it sounds like something's raking out in the forest. That's a really weird sound. I don't like that. It's creepy. Oh, it's the swinging stuff, my bad. Can you open? We made it.
Recognize the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Oh, the deer.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. Spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy.
Stucky's the one who tried to run us the keys outside.
Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Okay. Oh, that's disturbing. Sorry, I was responding to a message from my friend Heather. And there's an article about how the woman who supposedly predicted 9/11 predicted some kind of nuclear explosion for 2023. And I'm just like, you know what? I don't wanna hear about that. We're so close to one right now, it's not even funny. Alright, you guys, I'll be right back. I have to go to the bathroom. Guys, I'm back. Sorry, everybody. All right, let's do this.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
I don't think I've ever gotten that one before.
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV.
That was weird.
Crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Ah! Sorry. The update on my computer was horrifying. What? Oh. Oh, there's the phone. Okay.
Great Ball Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen. I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed.
Oh yeah, that's right. And then he went crazy and axed some dude.
Ah, that's weird. How is an island gone? So where the fuck was I at the beginning of this game? The fuck? Well, all right. Episode one is done, guys. I don't remember how many episodes there are.
She's missing. Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at, but the cabin had disappeared.
How many chapters are in Alan Wake? Six. Just six chapters. So this isn't a long game at all. How long does it take to complete Alan Wake?
Honey.
Literally, that's it. 11 hours. This game is short.
These shots are turning out great.
I guess you're gonna need that coffee then. I'll go put it on.
Sick, a coffee furnace. I don't think I've ever grabbed that in during this little bit here. Just give me a minute. Oh, there's a manuscript in this vision? Oh, wait a minute. Oh, that definitely means I missed some in Nightmare. Yo, you guys, we missed like four pages, which I don't understand. Oh, these can only be found in Nightmare difficulty? Yeah, that'll never fucking happen. Are you insane? I will never play this game in Nightmare mode, no. We're never gonna get all the manuscripts, and I'm okay with that, because I won't play this game in midnight, Nightmare mode. Fuck that shit. We're just playing through once, the 11 hours, beating the game, and then we're playing Control.
This was a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red, a gruesome slushy, dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped.
This is so graphic sounding the way he describes all this.
Becoming one with it. I can see them now. My wife and my baby.
Baby?
Honey, I'm...
What is... Oh, okay. I don't know what's going on, but it's a very uncomfortable situation.
Return to sender, what I can't forget, Alex Casey, the things that I want, and the fall of Casey.
Is that a radio? Is that a QR code? QR codes didn't exist when this game first came out. Okay, I need to okay. What is this QR code for? It's a YouTube link.
Carried by the ebb and flow of different dream states. They seeped in from the reality beyond. Also things I couldn't explain.
It's some kind of like vision.
To make it real. So that the ones that weren't would become so. And there were visions that I knew were not real. Ideas I had lost. Often of Casey. For years. Use them as well.
Casey, those were those two bugs.
Feel true for them to become true. Always written this way. Even before, seeing things without realizing I was seeing them, thinking they were mine. Was this what inspiration was for me?
If that's vision number two, then where's vision number one? Did I miss a QR code somewhere? Okay, that was really fucking cool. And it looked, he looked different, like he had longer shaggy hair. So I wonder if that vision takes place after this game. It pays, apparently, to explore these visions. I wasn't aware of that. I've never explored during these little bits because I figured it wasn't important. Because it's a vision. What, how, you know what I mean? Like, it's a throwback. An old memory. I assumed there wasn't anything to them, but I guess I was wrong. I'm glad we explored.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly. These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan? Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry.
I'm right here, baby.
I'm fine, I'm fine. Just get the lights back on. Now, please.
Oh, okay. I was like, where? I don't remember this.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
She was awfully scared.
But it's just, especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
All right, now back to the present day.
How do you feel, Mr. Wake? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wake, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock.
Yeah, well, I mean, I was chased by murderous men surrounded by shadows that I had to burn away with my flashlight. Yeah. That pretty much covers up my fucking night. You just had a fish? All right. You redneck-ass motherfuckers. We're not leaving just yet.
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
Yeah.
The men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
No, because I don't know.
I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stucky's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see a wife.
Who is this?
Okay.
Lover's
Mr. Wake,
Peak.
Can I help you with anything?
Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal. We're watching you.
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
Hey! I'm sorry. Hey! I quit drinking for good. I need more.
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stucky's gas station with Thor.
Started shouting
no
like
sign of him.
There is so much yelling going on.
Look, we located the brake fluid. It's here. That's some good right. Driving it at the rehearsal today.
Would you shut up? My God.
Looks like someone really crashed the garage. Over. Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stucky. James out.
Alice looked through the viewfinder, lining up the shot. Cauldron Lake was breathtaking. Something caught her eye. A figure standing in the shadows behind the cabin, like a thin woman in a black dress. She lowered the camera and looked again. No one there. Just a collection of bushes that looked vaguely human-shaped. She shook her head and laughed.
You can get to the back lot through.
All right, I have to pee. Nobody cares where you want to be, bro. Oh, fuck. Okay. All right. That door and down the corridor, Mr. Wake. I know where I'm going.
Hey, can you turn the light? The light's on. The deputies, they won't.
In spite of its human mask, to describe the dark presence as intelligent would have implied human qualities on something decidedly inhuman. Nonetheless, it found the one spot in the diner that was dark enough. Some light spilled into the corridor, ravaging it. But it took the pain. Horrible as it was, the writer would soon fix that. He would be coming to the one place where it still had power.
Oh boy.
They don't understand. They won't listen to me. Hey, you! Can you help me? Can you? Thank you, man. Thank you. Hey, you're all right. You're a good guy. Don't let anybody tell
the
you.
Early morning.
Thanks, you drunk fuck.
Phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Well, folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep.
Oh! Mother, I'm home!
The kidnapper fired his gun one last time, and the shadow vanished into the darkness it had come from. See? Nothing to it, Wake. The thought of Alice in his hands was revolting. We stood on the wooden platform of Lover's Peak, the waterfall on the mountain behind us, the lights of the radio mast blinking red in the heights above. I fought with the urge to take a swing, forced myself to speak. Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife?
Yeah, where's my wife?
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The caller meant business.
Barry?
Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow, what the hell is going?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Shapes it from nothingness, the way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies.
Okay.
Darkness will reclaim it. It's
marvelous, sir. I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused on their recent and regrettable little outing. They are not accountable for their actions, of course. I can assure you that my staff has been reprimanded.
Tor and Odin never caused any trouble to anyone when they were still living at their farm.
Indeed. All we can do is to slow down the progress of their dementia.
Ah, he's talking about those two old rocker men from the cafe.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on...
My situation?
Up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh, hey! Oh, my!
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move. Get your hands off of my client.
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
I don't like your offer.
Get me out of here.
What the hell was with the paparazzi. I thought they were going to lock you up.
Yeah, there's some crazy shit happening, bro.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money. And he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr. Wake! Barry, you found him!
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee.
Great, he says. I love that you were just thinking about me, bitch.
Later.
Who's Max?
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you.
Yeah, Alan. Don't be a butt plug.
Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car, just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? What, are you high? Have you been drinking?
Oh my god! He's so annoying.
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week. And someone's got Alice. Do you and understand just... what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong.
Wait here.
The story could be a bestseller.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. Yeah, I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure.
All right.
Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing is... Listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha-ha, let's have a laugh on Barry.
Hi, Barry.
Real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually.
All right. End of the nature trail. Let's go. Get the keys and get the fucking car.
Al, you're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him.
Yes!
You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with two long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills.
Maybe that's what I need. Lock me up and throw away the key.
Al. Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her. This is not a goddamn debate, Barry.
Who's he?
I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
Achoo! Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous.
These yokels.
Nobody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Ew, Don't reference deliverance. I've never seen it, and all I hear are horrible things. Nope, 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 no, no, yes. Okay, there has to be a manuscript here somewhere. Come on. Nowhere? This whole cabin. Not a single manuscript. No, stop. Let's run around the house for a minute. Hey, another coffee thermos. There's two of them here. Astra, raindrop. Yeah, you do whatever the fuck you have to do, bro.
Barry had never gotten along with Alice, but he knew Ellen loved her with an almost frightening intensity. And now something had happened to Alice. And here was Al armed with a gun and saying things people got put in padded cells for.
Oh, shit!
As if his friend had experienced a massive psychotic episode and was now totally disconnected from reality. It scared the shit out of Barry.
Because I'm losing no control.
Barry got the keys to the car he rented. Wasn't a long walk to the visitor center, and it wouldn't be any use to me in the forest.
You're gonna make me go on foot? No, that's not right. I'm supposed to drive this. All right. I guess not.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
Oh.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc, what's your dear best plan like? My plan?
Where's my... I don't have a gun. Oh, I don't like that that's just swinging. Oh, fuck. Oh. Oh, I don't like this. It was, like, rumbling. Like, what the hell just happened? Man in the mirror.
He's inside, Agent. He's a weird one.
I like these little episode thingies. So they don't believe that this guy killed this dude that he's being blamed for killing. He was killed by his mirror self. Okay. Not staying here for any more of this. Hey, a manuscript.
Certainly taught her the value of a man who was gentle. He treated her well, made her smile, made her feel good. But Rusty wasn't the prince of her dreams, and that tended to underline the unbearable truth. She was no closer to that Hollywood magic than he was. Some rotten drowned thing had crawled up from its grave.
Ew.
Rusty kept coughing blood. My eyes were drawn to the twisted shape of his broken leg. The attack had been vicious. Max whined in his cage. Rusty's eyes were wild with fear and terror. He gasped. Mr. Wake, it happened just the way it was on that page.
Oh, what? So the pages are coming true.
Pokemon!
The vision left me weak. This was no head injury.
Rusty, hang on!
Oh God,
I'm coming!
Please, help me! Help me! Help! Help me! Can you hear me?
Mr. Wake?
Oh, hell. It happened just the way it was on that page. I found. Came true. It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must. The lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back.
Yeah, don't die on me, bro.
Couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened. Shh. Good boy.
Okay, wait a minute, what?
The sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on. The visitor center was sturdy, but the impact turned the front of the building into splinters. Rusty was thrown across the lobby like a rag doll.
Like a rag doll.
It didn't hurt until he tried to move and saw his leg bend the wrong way. Blech. Broken ribs stabbing him from the inside. Rusty howled in pain and fear, suddenly afraid to die alone.
Ew. His leg is bending the wrong way. That's so gross.
Instant, I changed direction and threw myself down. The axe splintered the trunk of a tree. I stumbled into the pool of bright light. My lungs burned. I was too exhausted to move. I tensed as I waited for the killing blow, but it never came. I raised my head.
Stop moaning, I'm trying.
Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
Rusty!
The ground was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness. Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
Oh, God.
Please don't feed the animals.
What? Boss fight. Holy shit, okay. Bitch, fuck off. I'm gonna totally stock up on all the ammo that I can take right now. Time is it? Okay, guys. Have to get ready to wrap this up soon. I forgot how much I really like this game and how, like, genuinely terrifying this game could be at times. No? Okay. I don't know. It kind of felt like. Oh, it's not my favorite. I've already played this game. I just really like it. I'm more, the reason why I really want to play this is I'm more interested in playing Control. Control looks amazing. So Barry saw one of these creatures. Yeah, Control is a sequel spin-off to this game. And now a direct sequel to this game is right now being made. And from what I understand, the sequel to this game is going to be less action and more exploring and investigation. Which is actually, in my opinion, will be really cool, especially since you're trying to play a writer. I think it'd be cool. I think it's going to be cool that the next game is going to be less about actually fighting against things and more of investigating more into this darkness. I, like, can't wait for the sequel. But yeah, I heard Control is, like, really, really, really good. I'm, like, super excited to play it. I saw the trailer, and I played, like, an hour of it on Game Pass. But then I, like, looked up the game online and found out that it was a spinoff from this. And I was like, oh, well, I never finished Alan, so obviously I'm not going to play Control. Okay. Oh my God. It definitely only showed two of them, not three of them. How's it going? How's it going? I just about shit myself. That's how it's going. It's fabulous. Thank you for asking.
Seemed to know where Al was, but Rose, the waitress at the diner, had seen him. From what Barry could tell, Al pretty much fell off the face of the earth when he left the diner. Rose was just the kind of fan that Al hated, but she really tried to help. She was smart, too. Knew a lot about what was going on in the town. Knew a lot about Al. Even knew who Barry was. Barry liked her. That was no big surprise. When it came to women, Barry and Al rarely saw eye to eye.
Just shit yourself, Barry. Don't let anyone ever tell you you're not allowed to. I like the way you think, my friend. Sometimes the bathroom is just too far away. Ew, it's so gross. This is one of those endless wave sections. And unfortunately, because of how tired my stamina bar is, I can't just, like, run. Who wants some of this? Huh?
Pokemon!
I turned the corner, afraid of what the flashlight's beam might reveal. Suddenly, a roughly painted symbol of a torch glowed in the light. Behind it, hidden by a rock, sat a battered metal trunk. It was here for a reason, packed with supplies, batteries, flares, ammo, things you need to make it through the darkness of the night. Something left behind by someone who knew what I knew, and more.
So somebody was prepared for this, and marked things on purpose because they knew I was going to need it. So who... Yo, I'm actually really excited to get to the next game, Control. Because I'm dying to know what all of this is. And I guess there's some articles about Alan Wake in Control. Like, investigative reports and stuff. So, like, they further explain some stuff that happened. Alright, we're gonna go a little bit further into this game. But not much longer. It's almost time to wrap this up. That is not... Are you serious? Did that seriously just happen? I switched guns! You just wasted one of my fucking flares, you dumbass! I wanted you to switch to my handgun! Oh, you dumb ass fuck! Ah! Mount St. Helens erupts in 1980. Interesting. I wonder if these are real places from Washington State, because I lived in Washington State. I don't think Bright Falls is a real place, but I'm wondering if some of the stories might be real. I mean, Mount St. Helens definitely happened. I learned about that when I lived there. Agent Nightingale?
Revolted him, and he didn't like the trees or the coffee. He now knew that impossible horrors lurked behind the storefronts and smiles.
Who's Agent Nightingale?
Around and just drive until he passed out or ran out of road.
I don't remember this. I know of Florence Nightingale, but I'm pretty sure she killed people. I think she was like a nurse or something, home nurse. Ow. Jesus. Oh, fuck you!
Come on, we gotta get moving. More of them coming.
Thank you? I don't remember this. Oh, yes I do. Okay. He gives me flares. Okay. This is where I get the flare upgrades. Okay. 30 minutes left, guys, and then we are all done.
I see him. Come on, we gotta move.
Why?
Because that's the way the story goes.
Yeah, but
let's move.
I lost my gun back there.
Oh, I've got a gun. Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first arrived here with Alice. He knew my name. We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
Come on, Wake! You better keep up!
Seriously, dude? Can you fucking hit your goddamn target? You would think being AI controlled He would be better at this. This is ridiculous.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do, Wake.
Are you kidding? Give me the gun!
No time for back talk. Hold him off, damn it.
Fuck you! I don't.
Are you feeling better now, Wake?
You told me to go on.
They'll be on us soon.
You told me to go on. I did. Don't get mouthy with me, prick.
This is it, Wake. Last stand. More players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
That's not how this goes. Get with the program.
Wait, there's coffee! I was like, I can't fight, dude! Alright, I forgot how much I hated this part.
Let's cut the
it's not fair that I don't have a gun of any kind.
I knew you were gonna say that. I read it all before. You're a hell of a writer. Congratulations. You're gonna bring about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
What the hell are you talking about? Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript, or she's gonna suffer bad.
Touch her off.
Somebody sent me a game on Discord. I'm gonna have to watch the video after. Yeah, I'll kill you.
And he wanted the manuscript because he thought it held some magical power.
but I had no manuscript to give him. I had to get... On more than one occasion, Alice had tried to explain to me how it felt to be afraid of the dark. To her, darkness wasn't simply the absence of light, but something more tangible than that. It was something you could touch and feel. Worse than that, it was something with a mind of its own, something malicious and malign. For her, things changed when they were wrapped in darkness. They turned into something else, something foreign.
Okay.
Back to Barry and figure out my next move.
So she was, like, genuinely horrified of the darkness. I don't remember that. Traps? I don't remember that at all. That sucked. Wait a minute. The batteries recharge in the flashlight, and I have to remind myself that sometimes so I don't spam refilling the batteries. I dodged that! Fuck you, he hit me! He did not hit me. I literally did the little sweep to the left. Like, really? That hit registered? I don't buy that. Oh, my motherfucking God. I'm exhausted.
The flashlight was heavy in my hand, and each pull of the trigger sent a painful shock up my arm. But I was finally out of the woods, and things were looking up. That's when I heard the chainsaw.
Chainsaw? Fucking chainsaw? Motherfucking chainsaw? Bitch, we got fucking chainsaws. Oh, I don't want no chainsaw. No, I don't want that. I don't... No. Don't say sh... Fuck! No, I think this is a good place to save it. This is a good place to stop and save it. Okay, guys, we're gonna go ahead and wrap it up here. This is a checkpoint. Next Friday, we might play some more of this as well. Or we might go back to Xenoblade for a day and then come back to this the following Friday. I haven't decided. Only because we're so close to finishing Xenoblade. And this is only 11 hours long, so it's, like, really fast. In fact, how many hours are we in now? Oh, you're not going to tell me? No, you're not going to tell me. Okay. This is what I'm going to try to... I'm going to see if I can do this. And then... Sometimes the saves are... under something. And you can check how long your save is, but I don't know where it is. And I'm not gonna mess with it. Okay, well, today is Friday, which means it's 50-50 if I'll be back later tonight or not. If I am on tonight, it'll probably be just some multiplayer shit. Maybe some Dead by Daylight, maybe some, I don't know, something. And if I'm not back tonight, I won't be back again until Sunday. Saturday is my big show that I'm performing in mass, my paid gig, and I will not be here for a stream at all Saturday, not at all. Like, nothing is happening Saturday. Sunday I will be back, for some Disney Dreamlight. There's a new event, new stuff going on. Sunday night I won't be because I'm pretty sure I am booked to perform my usual Sunday show, which is necessary. I am trying to save up for a car because it looks like I might not be getting that car that we were hoping Barry was getting. All right, guys. So thank you for tuning in. I had a lot of fun. And I will see all of you Sunday. All right, guys. Barry out.